And welcome everybody here on Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some sneaky Yasuo. It's going to be our next deck. Thank you, Kitty Dexterity, for the cheer there. So sneaky Yasuo is where, of course, we're going to be a Yasuo deck. We're going to be Yasuo Leona over here, but we're playing this new card from Call of the Mountain, Sneaky Zeebles. There's a card we haven't played yet. So 5 mana, 3/3 elusive that whenever you play it, you stun all enemies with 2 or less power. So that can help out with having a Yasuo in play, and it curves Yasuo into Sneaky Zeebles, where if you have this in play, then of course, Yasuo, whenever you're stunning anything, you're dealing 2 damage to it. So then you can use Sneaky Zeebles as like a one-sided avalanche, kind of, with that combination. And does a whole bunch of stun that can help level up Yasuo as well. So putting those two together, and then decided to go ahead and go with the Leona package, because these Daybreak cards are kind of the best thing to be doing early, and they also give us some good cards late with Solari Priestess and the Invoke. A couple Infinite Mind Splitters in the late game also. It's another great card with Yasuo, of course, stunning more things. And Infinite Mind Splitter is just super powerful. So we got a couple of those at the top end as well. And that's going to be our deck. So let's give it a try. So we're just playing over in normal. Of course, today's meme tier Monday. We're going to try Sneaky Zeebles for the first time. That's a fun name to say as well. So may not be playing any units with power 2 or less. May have some. Obviously, Anivia could be one here. Ooh, we do have Yasuo into Sneaky Zeebles. Let's just keep those two. Right, we want to keep our combo. Then we'll look for some earlier things to play. No, I need off days too, morning tea time. Especially with all the editing, my work days are really long these days, and I haven't taken an off day since the 11th. A little over 3 weeks ago.
Fresh catch? Well, it was fresh.
I'm just passing.
Let's see what's out there.
I'd rather attack with the 3/3 Solari Soldier next turn, and then we also have Pill Cascade with a Nightfall. So just good reasons to wait. The reason not to wait would be like we draw a 2-drop that we'd want to play this turn. Like a Fae Blade Twirler or something, but we can always wait till the next turn to play that anyway.
Hey, what's that? Man overboard!
So I guess I'm going Zenith Blade on this thing. I mean, I have nothing else to do. We're gonna just save the 3 mana. So I'll still get 2 mana, so it only costs me 1 mana to Zenith Blade the Solari Soldier. Which then I guess the Solari Soldier gets through Oblivious Islander. Yeah, I mean, I might as well. We just draw, I mean, it's not like we waste Zenith Blade, we draw another one. So might as well. Alright, go get him Yasuo. They could have Anivia this turn.
Nothing escapes my watch. I face my fate. Your turn.
So Stalking Shadows grabbed Avarozen Sentry. That's pretty nice.
Feels like a bacon. Oh heck! Alert the village.
Alright, we got 2 damage on him.
If they're out there, I'll spot them.
Sneaky Zeebles. So Tryndamere is their other champion?
The chains! They never stop!
It's like a They Who Endure deck.
Light the signal fire!
Coming in hot!
That's of course what Warden's Prey made.
Victory at any cost!
Get closer to leveling up our Yasuo.
Asirio!
Get that out of here. We get to go straight to attacks.
Not done yet.
Mm-hmm.
right, down to 8. We're at 3 out of 5 for Yasuo.
Spirit of winter awaken.
Let's see what we got. Take meteor shower, I guess.
Light warms the heart and lights the way.
I don't love any of those.
For my homeland.
No mercy for heretics.
Strike them down.
This may make it a little easier for my like meteor shower and concussive palm to like take down the Anivia. Now, I expect that they want to bring the Anivia back. Like they want it to die.
What does he want from
and then
me?
Bring it back with different things.
Our strength is forever at its zenith.
Blessed Ooh. Daylight surrounds you.
Try to get this out of grass to the undying range. Cool.
Devotion to battle.
Life and death on a blade's edge.
My spirit shines.
They're at 8 right now.
I want to go home.
I will endure.
So that is 8. All right, harsh ones make sense.
I protect this place. Rest in ice. Have faith.
So they're not going to be, they're not going to get the Agnivia back this next turn.
These old eyes still see far and clear.
So we get both with this. We get the Daybreak and the Nightfall. We get the Daybreak because of the Robin. And then it's Nightfall, so we get them both. Cool. Create another Infinite Mind Splitter. And there we go. GG's. That's a pretty nice Robin.
I will regain my honor.
Creating that. This could be another good Sneaky Zeebles matchup. Stunning a bunch of 2-power things. Leveling up our Yasuo. Okay. I want to look for Yasuo. So just mulliganing pretty aggressively. I think Yasuo is going to be very important. And no Yasuo, but we still got Leona into Robin. That's not bad. Basically Arachnoid Sentry. It costs 4 mana.
Osu can sniff out any star anywhere.
Think you're fast? Cute.
Where are you at, Yasuo?
I'm still good to scrum!
How did you get to know so much about stars, Soraka?
Well, it's a long story.
It's a great combo. Why do you cost 5 mana, Will of Ionia? Why don't you cost 4?
My faith protects me.
Be at peace.
Should have stayed home, pal.
Live yeah, probably. This didn't work out very well. No Yasuo. Yeah, I guess we play Leona.
The power of the immortal sun.
It just uses my mana so much better than playing Solari Soldier. We'll wait on Solari Soldier after Robin.
I will find the goodness in you, River King.
Who only provides temporary sustenance, child? I'm sure there's something for my tastes.
Nope, nothing for your tastes. Well, they have it all. The 4 best cards in their deck. Starspring, Soraka, Boxtopus, Tom Kench. So they got everything. What do we do against everything?
Strike while the planets align.
Warriors of the Raharaka.
No, I don't really have any good options.
We'll follow you to the edge of Daybreak.
Well, we're going to Will of Ionia eventually, I suppose.
Start the round. Where are you off to?
Take heart.
Trespassers!
It's such a difficult deck to play against. I just wanted Yasuo and Sneaky Zeebles. Those are the only two things I wanted. I'm gonna get either one. Sneaky Zeebles would also been, you know, would have been great with the Yasuo. That's what I wanted.
I feel better when you feel better.
The possibilities are infinite.
Hey Michael, good afternoon. Wow, menu. Well, I tried my best. I mulliganed all four cards. Can't do anything else.
Don't let the fluffy tails fool you.
Bless the faithful and fear the heretics.
All right, Michael, you have a donation deck. Can you tell me what it is?
Plenty of room inside.
Crundle, Tom Kench. Cool. All right, we'll do.
Appetizers of plenty.
You leave me no choice.
Round them up!
Right, right. Should have stayed home, pal.
Take heart. Live with purpose.
Power that four-hour might.
I wish we could draw a card with Pill Cascade, but we can't. Unless they play something else here, then I get to Pill Cascade. Hey, Errol.
Behold the divine power of the sun.
Welcome back, Jake. Haven't missed too much.
Divine light shines within.
We're playing a Yasuo Sneaky Zeebles deck. Game one, we had Yasuo and Sneaky Zeebles, and those two cards were great, and we won fairly easily. Game two, we mulliganed all four cards looking for Yasuo and Sneaky Zeebles. We did not find either.
I will find,
and it looks like we are
hope only provides temporary sustenance,
not going to be winning. All right, go to the next one. Sunset. Alright, playing against scouts. What do I think about Solari Priestess? One's going away. Do I want the other one against scouts? No, we'll just ship them both. Okay, cool. Like what we got here. So my theory on scouts is that it's a lot better deck than it used to be. And that's basically because they started to play a lot more challengers. I think the challengers are just amazing, especially with Misfortune and with all the pump spells. Like, I think challengers are just incredible. And alright, so the But anyway, but you know, now they start playing Blighting Assault and Laurent Protégé. Like, they weren't playing Laurent Protégé before. And that card, I think, has made this Scouts deck much better. So we get Zenith Blade here. But then the problem is I don't have Yasuo plus two extra mana next turn. And I think I really want Yasuo plus two extra mana next turn.
I'm one of the good guys, but not that good.
No, maybe not. Maybe I just go like this. All right, I definitely regret playing the Zenith Blade right now and not having the two mana, because I could have, you know, I could have had Steel Tempest. Yeah, this is pretty awkward.
Love ya.
the road takes me.
All right, so this will give me the, this will give me like the 3 mana still.
I'll show you the sights of Bilgewater. The sights are fine. The smells, on the other hand.
I face my fate. Your turn.
All right, so next turn I'll have Sneaky Zeebles and 4 mana. So Sneaky Zeebles with Pale Cascade, Steel Tempest.
No closer.
Wish you were 3 or less power, Sneaky Zeebles. Also, I just wish I didn't play that Zenith Blade on turn 3. This would be a lot different.
Believe or burn.
I guess I gotta bounce this misfortune. You can kinda tell I need a day off tomorrow. I just have played this game very poorly. That was a terrible game by me. I'm sorry.
I've always believed in second chances.
All the best cards in their deck. So I guess that's gonna happen sometimes. So you know, even if I don't play a Zenith Blade, we're probably not winning that because they just had everything. But I could have put myself in a better spot.
A little luck for those who need it. Be brave.
Don't see Gift Giver. Like, you know, I was expecting, you know, like all this dragon stuff. Gift Giver is a little surprising. Wasn't expecting that one.
Cute. The skies darken with their approach.
Haven't done very much with the Blade Twirler yet.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way.
Probably need this as like a way that we maybe draw Yasuo.
Ours is the one true light.
All right, lots of Pale Cascades.
Dragon blood, Demacian heart.
Let the blood boil, half dragon.
Punish transgressions.
Leona, no. Wrong champion. But Leona does work with the Fadeblade Twirler, I suppose.
Suffer my fury.
The dawn has arrived. With its light, the Solari will unite the heavens.
A dragon's
good card. Maybe I need to just be firing off the Pale Cascades.
Raise your weapon, Sunwind.
Alright, so Leona leveled up. Just, you know, basically fire them off to just draw cards. So that probably means Aurelion Soul next turn.
Stand and fight!
Devotion to battle!
This is your end.
All right, getting Shyvana out of here so they don't get the free strafing strikes with Shyvana.
Now I take to the sky.
Oh. I don't know what an RTS game player is. I don't know what RTS means. The non-TCG game that I've been playing over the last couple of months has been Deep Rock Galactic. That one's a lot of fun to play. Okay. Real-time strategy? No, I've never really played those.
The Star Forger himself.
You rang.
Love to have Infinite Mind Splitter here.
Clad in shining sunlight.
Yeah, no, I've never played StarCraft before.
They say these were from the Protector himself.
My, how they stare.
How does anybody ever beat Aurelion Soul? Especially Aurelion Soul on turn 7. How does anybody ever win? Really help, you know, like they already used the +2/+2. Cool. I was gonna say they already used like one of those +2/+2 and gain, you know, gain the ability to block elusives. They already used one of those. Glad they didn't use another. Alright, so they have all zero mana celestials now. Should be pretty rough. I do have a deny if they have like the one that like exiles things or obliterates things. I don't really want to use it on that thing. So that's pretty rough. I don't get the Nightfall bonus. Now I can't play the Solari Priestess at Daybreak. That's pretty rough for a couple of reasons. No, thank you.
Sometimes you just need a galaxy destroyed. I am change.
So I could deny the Strafing Strike. We can win this one. We can beat Twisted Fate Ezreal. There's not any huge celestial being ready to take us down. And we have Yasuo. So that's good.
Raise your weapon, Sunwind.
Okay, we got one drop turn one with the attack token. That's new.
Without me.
I would love for them to block, but they shouldn't block.
Say your farewells.
That's a very poor block. They should just take three, and then I have a 2/2, and they have a 3/3. But we'll take that. We got our one mana card was a 2/1. So that's pretty awesome.
Think you're fast? Cute.
Plan on playing the Solari Priestess. Alright, so our one mana card was a 2/1, and now our two mana card's a 2/1. Our three mana card is going to be a 2/1 as well. We'll grab Traveler and keep on going. Those are all great options.
You'll fight or you'll swim!
May all those cool.
That could be pretty useful later. I know I could do that the other way around. But yeah, with Mega Rain, I'll take this. I'll just take this trading. I want them to play that and kill those things before we get our champions out here. Well, that's too bad.
Bless the faithful and fear the heretics.
Alright, so that's a third daybreak for Leona. That's too bad. That was a good one for them to take.
Bask in her radiant blessing. The dawn has
so, of course, it would be nice to have the Blade Twirler in play first, so the Blade Twirler get the plus 2 plus 0. But then we don't get the Daybreak, right? So we can't play Blade Twirler first and then Leona, because then Leona doesn't have Daybreak anymore.
Behold the sun's holy light. Have faith.
Big blade for a little warrior.
Underestimate me. I dare you.
Alright, our deck's doing its thing. Doing our thing.
Follow the horizon.
We'll just attack first and then hopefully be able to play one of these Daybreak cards afterwards. Hopefully we don't need to play Deny. Yeah. What, they're doing the damage upstairs? I guess they wanted to turn on Plunder. Usually you'd want them to target, like, you target two units for Ezreal, but I guess they have Plunder cards. So yep, there we go, there's Pilfer Goods. And they play some small unit.
There's plenty of killing left.
We stun it.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way. Sunlight blinds.
I'm gonna take this Written in Stars, where maybe, you know, we'll get like one of these other champions, but like maybe if they have like a Riptide Rex that like blows up the whole board and everything, that we can refill with Written in Stars.
My faith protects me.
Ours is the one true light.
So we're at that three.
Glorious light rains down.
Underestimate me. I dare you.
Alright, so we're at three. They're killing Leona. Alright, we'll let them kill Leona. And I guess I just do that next turn. So he'll make, if I play right now, it makes Yasuo a 4, but then that's it. Like, the 2 damage doesn't matter. Yeah, I guess we just do this next turn.
Daylight breaks on the battlefield.
Takes out a blocker. And I still got plenty of mana with 9 mana. Not let them turn on Plunder this time.
No cure, fools.
Behold the sun's holy light.
So they're going to be able to, like, they'll have priority first. So they're going to be able to play something anyway. So I don't get to just like concuss the palm and then go to my turn. So like we'll see if they play something. Like maybe they Mystic Shot my Yasuo and I can surprise level up Yasuo now. Okay, because I was gonna say like Thermogenic Beam. Would have been able to do that as well. So I don't get the 3-2, but take away a blocker, and that should be game. I told y'all we'll get this one. All right, over to 2 and 3. Not bad. Not bad. GG's.
One step closer to redemption.
Okay. So there we go. That's the kind of you know, hand that you need. You need, you know, like your, like an early thing or two first, and then Yasuo on four, them not kill Yasuo, and then you have like a bunch of stun stuff to go with the Yasuo, which we had with the Leona that then we played on at turn five. You know, you have that kind of game. That's what we had games one and game five, those games that we won. Pretty good there. Two of our three losses were against opponents that it probably didn't really matter what we had. They just had everything, and they just kind of just crushed us, like it wasn't close. And I think they would have just basically what I'm saying is I think they would have crushed most any deck I would play. They just had great hands. So that was two of our three losses. But Sneaky Zeebles looked good. I liked Sneaky Zeebles. 3-3 elusive. Got to stun a bunch of stuff. I liked this card. This card looked pretty good. I think it was a good card. Especially when you have Yasuo in play, and so that stun is dealing 2 damage. I think that's an awesome combo. It's a cool card. It's fun to say. Sneaky Zeebles. Yeah. Thumbs up. All right, those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there. And of course, feel free to leave those comments as well. Always love seeing those. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.